All right.
We're live. All right, we're outside the federal courthouse and this might actually...
No, it's good.
We're outside the federal courthouse in Pittsburgh, the trial of Jordan Miles versus Salvute and all, et al. In January 2010, Jordan Miles was walking from his mom's to his grandmother's home and was stopped and searched by three police officers who didn't identify themselves, according to Miles. This is right in the way, dude. I'm gonna start again.
Yep.
Alright. We're standing outside the federal courthouse in Pittsburgh, Pennsylvania, for the trial of Miles versus Salvute et al. Jordan Miles was a high school honors student who was walking from his mom's to his grandmother's home in January 2010 when three white men jumped out of their car and ran towards him shouting, "Where's the drugs? Where's the guns? Where's the money?" He thought he was being mugged, so he ran and ended up slipping on the icy sidewalk in January and was overtaken by the three police officers who beat him brutally, including ripping dreadlocks out of his head and beating him while he was, like, after this had happened, when he was on the ground sort of praying the Lord's Prayer. He was a Kappa High School honor student. Kappa's like the performing arts, the famous school of Pittsburgh. He's a viola player. Jordan played viola for Michelle Obama and the First Ladies during the G20 and had never been in trouble with the law. And ironically, before all this began, he was going to study crime scene investigation. That was his plan for university. So we're outside the case. Today, the three cops, Richard Ewing, Michael Salvute, and David Sysak, and their lawyers, and the Miles family, Jordan, his mother, Therese, and his grandmother are all here. And it's jury selection day, which is open to the public, apart from one part. There's a discussion about race. The questions about views on race to the jury are not public. So this is day one of jury selection, day one of the trial. We're going to go back in there and give you an update once we know more about what's happening. And tomorrow and later tonight, there should be blog posts on justiceforjordanmiles.com where we'll try and post transcripts of what's gone on today and future days of the trial.